Thank you, Dr. Sung, for your introduction. And my topic, you know, my topic is, I mentioned democracy, because once when you mention democracy, you get lost. So finally, I try to use community, since this is more tangible, functional, and at least elite in your environment. So actually, the whole thing is about rebuilding China project, and actually rebuilding myself, because I did see the Twin Tower collapse and the airplane bumping into the two of them. And I was so shocked, I'm believing, horrified, and I didn't know what to do. And even though I have confronted a lot of trauma in China, but not this one. This one is really, really, you feel America the best, please, safe. You mean America is no more safe? Wow. So where would be safe? Anyway, this is, I try, okay. And, witnessing collapse and something for myself. And I also am a member of our group of modern MoCA and MAT and China Institute and many art groups. And so also I, not only just individually, but also I happen to have a group with a lot of time with the groups. I try to facilitate him as a silent partner, volunteer. And East River Waterfront project, this project is under the FDR highway, going to build waterfront and space. In that project, I propose the big space for Asian American, for whatever lore in that residence, because you know why? Because the Chinese, when you get together, you see more people together, you feel more like, you know, Asian, more like Chinese, more Asian. And because if we don't see each other, you know, in Manhattan, only the restaurant, Jin Fung, 1,000. And the Columbus Park, 300, 400. So that's it. And the more people, more get involved. And that's very, very group cohesion, and you feel your belonging. And I remember when we traveled to Mamish County, there's a senior group. It's a very big plum, you know, black man. He is a primary singer. So many white, you know, old. And the song, the name, I remember so clearly. Are you feeling belonging? Are you feeling blue? Oh, this dawned on me. So if you don't feel blue, you don't have belonging feeling, you feel blue. So this is why I dedicated myself to Chinatown, so I can feel belonging, you know, and help myself. Canal area, because Canal almost, in every summer, or every month, there's one woman, old male woman killed from Barbary and Canal Street. And it's a very, very hustling, bustling place. A Rebuild Chinatown initiative is sponsored by EFI, you know, Asian American for Equality. And they first apply for the funding from LMDC, Lower Manhattan Development Corporation. That corporation received 214 billions, 21.4 billions from approved by President Bush. And our culture council, this is supposed to be already, Alan, City Council Alan Gerson got 150,000 for feasibility study. Their goal is to get 68 meetings, but I don't know, this is still in the process, I don't know where it real life. Lori, this is Chinatown Empire Zone, and this we finally succeed. When 911 happened, and it's very interesting because the political situation in Binghamton, because that's a Republican Bruno, you know, they got first priority, they got approved, you know, the Empire Zone. New York, Louisiana, we didn't. After 1 year or two of political Muslim federal we got. And this means each hiring, you receive 3,000 tax deduction, each new hire. Coming to board, I get involved, you know, and my colleague and Kevin Ma, we will so serve on the community board. There's so many things. Recently, there's a liquor license and a burlesque is kind of hot dancing, you know, finally the community working together, and finally we prevail. We deny their application, even though they have a big shot, the policeman, the big lawyer, big publicist, but we still, the community won the whole battle. Community social service, this is 40 agencies. Every month, they have a meeting. Each month, it's just like HIV, AIDS, human traffic, and every month, cancer, all kind of thing. By the way, human traffic, because they're, you know, not because this agency advocate, but finally, Governor Spitzer signed human traffic law into law before the noon. And the Asian American Health Project, NYU Medical Center, and I did write a letter to mayor and to get money for hepatitis and the SARS and chicken flu, you know, chicken flu. And old Chinatown community structure and change many decades. It's 120, 130 years. And there's not much change. Community power fragmented because the power structure is vertical. And vertical, when Chinese American Planning Council apply, want to connect with this, with some of the agency, the old guard, they said, you young kids, you know, stay away, go away. So today, this agency is called Chinese American Planning Council, CPC. And the CPC now end up the largest social service agency. They have 104 meetings. And I just often I talk with the executive director, David Chen, and he said it used to be 6,000 one day. Now they serve 8,000 one day. Loose messenger, okay, this is very important. I like to share with you. Usually you don't, it's bugging me for many years. Finally, I went to a Puerto Rican seminar. And I asked Ruth Messenger, she was former board president. She said, politicians like to minority squabbling, fighting among them. You know why? You are busy fighting yourself. If I'm a politician, you have no time to bother me. So this is when you are consolidated, you build consensus, you say, then you are strong, you can threaten me, jeopardize my position. You demanding this, demanding that, make me very, very hard to deal with. Distrust unconnected, because this is not a sharing, you know, many Chinese don't want to share. This is a big problem. But it's much better now. There's no, not don't want to share, because if I share my secret, my information, give to you, you apply, then I have no, I couldn't get a slot. So this is a secret why many Chinese carry the mentality. Now it's much better now. The pressure group, there's no pressure group. Because there are several buildings designated for Chinatown, especially police building. I just, a few months ago, learned. Supposed to give to BIM, sub-BIM mayor, supposed to give Chinatown. No, they didn't, because this is kind of now it's a lot of luxury condo. And finally, when Chinatown CPC trying to get rent, the basement, oh, they give so much trouble. They feel the Chinese old age people using the basement, the cooking, they feel downgrade their value. Because Kevin Costner, his wife, for divorced wife, Jim Crawford, Crawford. And she had an apartment that many years, four, five, 6 years ago. Apartment, $2-3 million. No, we have no pressure groups. That's why the politician, you know, left the deal. Accountable leadership, no pressure group, no grassroots, no leader, no grassroots participation. And the number of vote, Edward Koch, they don't want to come to Chinatown, why? Because Chinatown has only 1,500 votes. It doesn't bother, it doesn't worth, not worthy, but not different. Now we have 25 to 30 vote. New China after. First rescue, this is the beginning of successful several attempts per field in the past 3 days. In the past, so many times, you know, it's very interesting, I have pointed out, this is very hard to conceptualize. Either Amanda or Betty, you help me. How to say this? When Chinese group getting together, I don't trust you, I don't admire you, I can do better than you. If American comes, they are good, we listen to them. So this is why after so many years, every time failed. But this time, 911 got it. Why? Because the government gave money, they build a track, the funding source to the government, and all the Chinese around the financing, or the granting scholarship, all this track. Therefore, they build a political mainstream political group. Community structure changed, emerging developed along the track of public, now we have a single agency. That's CPLDC, the Chinatown Partnership Local Development Corporation. They have the initial. Correct me, Betty, about 2 million for the budget, but now they have, I think, another 2 years, 208 or 209, they're going to finish. Now they have to start raising funds themselves. And partnership, yeah, between community and government. This is the first time the partnership among ourselves never achieved. I don't know why. And even before 911, there was a group almost done because garment factory, 500, boiling down, closing so many, only 200 left, the crisis. Then suddenly September 11 happened, this group collapsed too, again. So partnership between government and the community and the new leaders and the new professionals. Before, there's no, all regular, accounting and here, there, and now the city planner, urban designer, artist, we rarely see artists. You can starve to death, you're hungry, Now the art design, MBA manager, developer, we have a lot of developer now. So this help brings new idea and a new skill, new knowledge. And this new knowledge, all I would term as a democratic knowledge and a democratic skill. A new agency, new program funding, mayor's office for community affairs, federal, state, each government legislature, mayor office has Asian liaison. And even the latest is controller, Thompson, William Thompson, he's going to run mayor. Now he's also, a few months ago, he also created liaison, Asian liaison. It's very interesting, before known. So all current liaison, you can see the political power we have, quite. Government agency involved in China project, and that's why, I think government involved project, so the Chinatown people, leaders, all working, can work together much better than before. Lower Manhattan Development Corporation, this is, I mentioned, this is the primary agency. Review Chinatown, these are masters. They have eight, a preserve, old style Chinatown, new Chinatown, nightlife, construction, transportation, and all kind of project, for new Chinatown. Federation. 911 survey. That survey won a lot of approval. This is the first survey Chinatown has to win mainstream media and the mainstream politician, even mayor, praise this survey. Very, very authentic, very, very admirable by public and private. Coalition for Asia Children. And this agency, Coalition for Asia, it's the executive director is Wing Wong. He was just 2-3 years from California. He's young, new, and in a short time, I went to their recent seminar, and they just distribute all kind of funding resources. If I have funding resources, I would hold myself, I don't want to share with you, because you're a competitor. I don't have, but I so admire them. That's why I mentioned their name. They share, they publish, and they even publish all the city councilmen's name, phone number, the majority, their committees, to share with us. I call, it's very interesting, I don't know why. My computer skill is very bad. And I call Alan Gerson's office, I call Speaker Queen, also has a liaison. I just get nowhere. Finally, this agency, they call AACF, and the CAACF, and they really distribute all this basic, primary information. Bridging the gap between Asian American ACS. You know the Chinese, they don't know here. They work hard. They think, hey, children, 10 or 5 year old, stay home for a few minutes. I go to buy shopping, groceries. When I come back, it's all right. Then they cry, some neighbors call, then they get trouble. Then I have a case, you know, this teenager, about 16. And this girl, young adolescent, her problem because of her friends got pregnant. I don't know why she worries. She took insomnia, I forgot the name. And they swallow for two bottles. And finally, get immersed to Canal Hospital at work. And the compulsory, you got to receive therapy. So the mother there said, no, I don't want, I don't need therapy. I said, you have to, otherwise we report to child abuse. Said, okay, I come once. I said, no, yeah, at least you come 10 times. Then we talk about fee. You have to pay the fee. Oh, this is government from China. Don't pay the fee. Everything is government, free. I said, no, you finally bought it $10. Then after 10 sessions, I found this young lady. She's good looking and she's very delightful, but her speech has a lisp, speech. We have speech and learning education speech pathologist. I said, I want, you know, would it be better for her socially in the future? So no. She just pulled out, that's it. So we couldn't do anything. This is why bridging the gap. And when we took this, it's very interesting, ACS, Administration for Children's Service, when we approached them, you know what? They were looking for Asian American social workers. And we told them we're looking for ACS to work together because so many family trauma. Once we took away, there's another thing, once we took away, oh, the father hit, there's a print, fingerprint. You know what? The ACS refer to criminal court. Oh, yeah, because physical. Then it takes 1 month or two, transfer back to civil court. So you can see. So civil court then takes another 2-3 months, then drop the charge. So it's such a trauma for family. At least now, with more liaison, more communication, Chinese community and ACS, so less trauma. Family children suffer less trauma in separation court order. Chinatown committee, you know, and the community board too, before we didn't have. I was on the board too for 8 years. This is the first time, maybe because we together get more. We have three Asians, two of us, and there's one Korean, Raymond Lee also. And he happened to be chair of business committee, committee board too. So we, you know, the Chinatown committee, the first day, September 5th, so many people. Almost 100 people, all the major, even CCBA president came, you know, and sitting from beginning to the end, 2 hours. Okay, this new culture, this all this about the new culture, new space, new connections, because everything's new, it's new connection, new profession, new development, more participation, more high-land momentum. Whenever you see something on the newspaper, people more participate, especially in terms of CBS or some other radio pronounce, you know, some racial remarks about Chinese restaurant or something, and chicken, because they said there's red meat in the chicken broccoli. That's, you know, going on for a long time. So, and all this kind of program, we participation, we get involved through all these kind of group. Process, actually the democratic process. You know, we learn how to deal with each other, deal with issue, problem, we learn. So the whole thing comes from marginal community to mainstream community. And this is, as I create the word, sharing, participation, voter registration, fundraising is for politicians. Coalition achieving committee, because there's so many Cantonese speaking Mandarin and the Shanghainese and the Taiwanese and the Fujianese, there's so many. So at least we achieve some consensus, certain degree, even not much, but at least certain degree peace. So first Democrat, this is also I got involved. Yeah, this agency, like you to know, the Chinese American Voter Federation. 华裔联盟, 投票联盟, we sponsored the first Democratic mayor candidate debate. You know, this is very ambitious. The chair, the president, York Chen, and he told me, she said, "Hey, Edward, I couldn't sleep for three nights. You know why? I worried the audience don't come. You know, Ferreira, Virginia Field, Anthony Weiner, and the, you know, all the congressmen, oh, they don't come. They did happen before, they don't come. Number one. Number two, what about Chinese don't come? You know, Chinese don't come. You worry. Then we hit the lotto. They all came, packed, the basement packed. And I told him later, I said, I didn't sleep that night. That's May 2nd. Yeah, did I mention May 2nd? That, oh yes, May 2nd. And I didn't sleep because I was so excited. And I realized that Democrat-sponsored Democratic mayor candidate, equivalent to, as I see, you know, from 1822, the Chinese Exclusion Act, 1964 Civil Rights Act passed. And this is the first time, of course, California much better, more progress than here, but at least in New York we achieve. Okay, not only there, after less than 3 weeks, about 3 weeks, you know what? The governor's office called Chinatown to have press conference. Wow, we got the sky, you're going to rain, red rain. Oh, wow, we couldn't believe. And a major press, and there's a governor and the mayor together. It happened to be they are Republican. As I see, I read their mind, it's my interpretation. If you Republican don't come to Chinatown, Chinatown would be taken over by Democrat. So they better come. And so they came. And they came, they announced $800 million. Can you imagine? $21.4 billion. Last very small potato, $800 million. Very small. And but it's good things they give to Chinatown $32 million. God. They could give $10 million if we are happy. They give $32 million, not bad. For sanitation and transportation. So this whole process, as I see, at least we build political leverage, Democrat and the Republican. And more than that, Association, and Mr. Chow, Eddie Chow, and he told me he rent the Mayor Bloomberg rent office in Yanchun Association. Wow, that's good. Not only like at cost, this is 1,000 miles ahead. Rent a room office in Chinatown for office. Chinatown office. Chinatown headquarters for Bloomberg for mayor. I said, did he pay? Yes, he paid. I said, how much? 1,000 rupees. Okay, good. Did you take the money? Sure, why not? I said, you are violating the Chinese culture. Chinese, all the government officials come to you, do you a favor. You always, no, you don't, I don't want your money. I'm glad he take the money. Everything's business is business. I am so glad. This is new Chinatown, new politician, and new culture. I'm so glad. So, you know, this is a demonstration, and compared to the Chinese, the continental, you know, railroad building that time, very small, just in encyclopedia, just one or two lines, Chinese, you know. But at least now we demonstrate, and we are able proudly to worship, to use this achievement as worship, as a, you know, contribute to their, to comfort our ancestors. Really, I'm really proud, you know, I think we all should, you know. And hardware, software, yeah, this is something. Hardware, I mean hard, housing, transportation, and all kind of development. Software means cars, Rolex, watch, hard, personal jogging, exercise, vacation, and social service, and counseling service, mental health charity. It's a very, very interesting, that's a very, very dichotomy. 1711 left, byproduct. Because over, it's really a little bit over, some overdeveloped. And left over, the so many problems, new immigrants, the trauma, new immigrants, and the left over, they just hush, you know, I do psychoeducational evaluation for children. Many parents, they don't know their children's school, they know their grade, they don't know many things about children's information. So all they know just go to school. One mother told me, oh, I just want my son to know how to write a check. That's it. I was write a check. So you can see this is the social survey, counseling, mental health, the community has not much attention. And I, myself, with several people, we try to emphasize, to rally the important things. And we all take care of the leftover, you know, the byproduct overdevelopment or hardware development. It's overdeveloped hardware or leftover, this kind of unemployment, factories, you know, or we have to take care of this. But on the other hand, the hardware service, they don't acknowledge software service. You know, this is, you know, we hope we can gradually improve linkage between family, community. Because a family stable, people, family stable, quality of living, and you can do better hardware, family support, community project. And rarely, family and the community are separate, you know, and the community is solid. If family support community, then this kind of support is solid, is health. The linkage between family and community, you know, like some many people going there, the husband were involved with the volunteer, the wife, children at home, they were complaining, oh, why you come late? Why you have to go out? You mind your own business. Why you mind other people's business? You know, so this kind of thing, and health fair, you know, reach out. I especially emphasize family dialogue, so important. Many family complain, oh, I didn't talk with my wife, I didn't talk with my husband, because they come home very late, working just money. One mother, very often when I was doing the clinical work, oh, my children don't sleep. At what time do they sleep? Oh, 11:30, 12. I asked the mother, what time do you go to sleep? Then the mother smiling. If the mother goes sleep late, of course. And some of the children, they're with the father. If the father don't see the father come home, their eyes never close. They have to wait the father come home. Yes, build individual emotional muscle with family support. If individually, it's always tough, you know, emotional muscle, emotional strength with family support. And community support means community healing. And the family support means family healing. This is very important. And the community consensus achieved, that means we are ready for mainstreaming. Reach out. Democracy means voting, participate in the healing. And literally, democracy, if we do everything democratically in the process, we mean healing. We feel we can help each other with, you know, hardware service overdeveloped, health service to ask for help, counseling, your family trouble. Because most of the family, they don't eat together. Now, less, the TV dinner, and some of the family, of course, this is some of the black family I see. Each room, there's one television, three bedroom, six, seven rooms. Each room there's one television. And they cook home. I said, how do you eat dinner? Oh, I just go to the refrigerator to get TV dinner. So each eat on their own. Less understanding, less fill up. So the individual feeling pent up and end up, you know, children fighting school and the emotional pressure build up, anxiety, depression, and the Chinese depression as a woman, suicide, and the old people very high, and the negative impact on job performance in the personal relationship. So it's indirectly impact the hardware development. Yeah, this is what I mentioned, multiple dynamic downing, you know, the downing I use, Albert Ellis, rational emotive, downing, going down, means low, I feel low, I feel impact, breakdown, individual family, depression, suicide. This all byproduct of hardware overdeveloped. Subgroup coalition, you know, 1882, committed gradual transforming. Act, and then 1963 civil rights. And the sixth civil rights signed by Johnson, Lyndon Johnson, president. And also because of Martin Luther King's march, I forgot where march. Now, Asian American pioneer contribution in building America today gradually acknowledged. I think the committee board too, the established Chinatown committee, that's one proof. We are coming there. And even interesting, people told me, the board said, you know, Ed, the already other ethnic group complained, I think that's Italian. We are here to be longer than you Chinese. Why we don't have Italian committee? I learned from Jim Sullivan, you know, a company. Building American graduate knowledge. So we have in Queens, we have already John Liu and Ellen Young for State Assemblywoman, John Liu City Council. And so very important thing they're doing, Chinese American World Federation, this is a new agency, vote public education. This is very important, public education. The democratic knowledge and the skill, a lot of things they don't know. They just, you know, they just, oh, I just want to vote for what? And I have proud to say, we are voting for expanding your school small room. We're voting for better repair your pavement. We're voting for better light. We are, you know, concrete connection, linkage between voting and facility of public facility. Otherwise, China, why vote? You know, nobody know why vote, nobody care. And when I was in hospital, a very college graduate, 2 years old, young lady, as we talk so many things about the political Chinatown. The next day I asked, did you vote? Oh, I didn't vote. I said, why? I was so mad. Because my mother asked me to do shopping, so I didn't have to vote. That's it. Anyway, this is a committee releasing, yes. Committee participation, this is very important. I wish people would hear more, understand. I connect family problem and community problem because poor participation, if they come to community, they talk with the people, their problem is no more their own problem. Oh, I see, oh, you have a problem too. You come to your husband, I come to my husband, I come to my wife. Oh, my children. Well, the problem is not my own. It's we share. When problems are shared, you know what? You feel strong for each other. You support each other. And release, healing. You will not pent up your feeling, individual or family tension. Release, you know, like a pot. You know, if you don't eat a very boiling water, boom, explosive. Volunteering, you know, many people doing one thing for others. Actually, this myself, I went to 2006, I went to San Francisco to make a presentation also about this volunteering, because it's really healing, individual healing, and it's not only help others, help myself too, because this kind of in and out, output, input, and the family, it's a very, very, very interesting interpersonal dynamics, interpersonal connection, and group dynamics, and the group, and cohesion, getting more. And I remember there's a famous Taiwan singer, Zhang Hui Mei. Of course, there are so many Korean, you know, singers. And this Miss Zhang said, oh, after the airport, girl, I'm so tired, I don't know whether I'm going to make on the stage to sing. So tired, told her manager. And finally, she went to the stage. She saw so many audience calling her name. Wow, wow, wow. She feel strength. She feel encouraged. She feel her battery recharged. So whenever you human contact, interpersonal, intergroup, ethnic group, intercommunity, the charge, the battery always charging, healing, just like this singer. Recharge instead of old-fashioned, you know what they use? Maybe they use opium or something, I don't know. That's why the singer or the theatrical people use, you know, they use opium. I wish they change their way of handle their emotion stress. So I think natural way of learning, growing, healing, individual, family, and the community, mutually supportive. It's very, very interesting. Chinese, you know, said, 见面, 三分情啊. We saw each other, you know, we will argue about money or whatever the problem. When we see each other, you know, there's something tension reduced. We are more working toward reconciliation, toward solution. 见面三分情啊. So that's why mutual support is more energy, more power, speed, morale. generated by such interpersonal. It's not magic. It's working all the time. Just we underutilize this strength, this resource, this source we underutilized. You know, everything we do on their own. This is why I joined the Chinese Community Social Service and the Health Council, 40 agents together. I work them. I try to, you know, harmonize them, coalition, connecting, and compromising. To more working together, the more power, more strength, more healing, more strength, more heat together. Subgroup coalition. This is hard. Regardless of dialect, we achieve consensus. It's a very, very beginning, I have to say. Not, I don't want to say, oh, we achieve consensus. No, very, very beginning. Especially Chinese American Voter Federation. That is really before the so many group arguing or squabbling, but at least we achieve consensus to sponsor the mayor, Democratic mayor candidate debate. Facilitated by our interaction group and not group cohesion to protest radio, there's so many broccoli chicken, Wen Ho Li, Muslim minister, especially Wen Ho Li and the minister, James E, they all accused violation in the jail. Finally, they all set free. They all free. We don't protest, we don't participate, we don't write a letter, we don't send email. The whole thing, is, you know, I don't think they are free today. Can you imagine still we have a long way to go? The park reopening, we won in court, but the police still not open because they think their security is still, they want to appeal, they want to, so it's quite a way to go, you know, all right? And so all I'm talking about, image uplifted, or identity improved, enhanced, we become all more authoritative. You know, because when I came here, studied the first year, you know, my supervisor said, yes or no, yeah. And my, yes or no, no or yes. I got confused myself. Yes or no, no or yes. You don't know, nodding or shaking your head. So, you know, community transformed, post-medicine for justice, equality, democracy, and quality living. So this is what is a good, it's a good result. Of course, we have a long way to go. In addition to this, we have so many things that's like Chinatown Arc. You know, the city council speaker last term, Miller, gave $250,000. Still in there, nobody talk about. But we're going to evoke this agenda. And Congresswoman Velasquez, and got $775,000 for Chinatown transportation. I know they end up still nowhere. Transportation still not yet, not grounded, not funded, you know. And, this is a channel. I thought I lost. Challenge recommendation, okay. I have, you know, I've been on the board, there's so many, maybe, I don't know, 8 or 9 board. I find myself, many boards are organized by crony, by friends, despite the qualification, crony, and, you know, in this way, many, many issue problems or community, many people not understand at all, you know. And so that's why I like to reason the quality of the board member. I wish I have the voice. I don't have enough voice. Expert instead of cronyism, favoritism. This is the problem. When a board organized by all these kind of unqualified people, you can see the function. Of course, they get, you know, money from government. Are they using the program wisely, or really, really deliver the needs, issue and the needs, problem, you know, linkage with the grassroots, you know, some of the questionable. This is one thing. Another established community council. All agencies should get together as a member election, a board, executive board. In other words, a president, a chair, and so that you can still hold power. But they delegate all this managing the work, daily affairs, decision making, contact, publicity, media relation, government contact, funding, fundraising, to professional manager. Many agencies doing this, but some still not doing it. That means we are still underutilized agency. We are not ready to promote, to move to modern community, the modern village of Chinatown. And they still like to hold old power, holding tight. They don't want to release it. That's a problem. So young generation will have to work hard involving this kind to make the professional manager getting a community council board and make every agency board accountable for this selection of the board. Okay, I think I stop here. And thank you for your attention. Thank you. Thank you.
We're going to take questions from the audience.
Yes, please.
Yeah, let's take some questions. You want me to help you, Ed?
Okay. Okay.
What Ed talked about was, you know, where were all you guys after 9/11? Or were you too young?
I was freshman year in high school when it happened. I wasn't really sure about what happened.
Only 6 years ago.
But I was really young then, and I wasn't really educated on life.
So I'm afraid that some of the young people don't know what happened. But I think Ed already mentioned on this thing that during the right after 9/11, they had all these regulations that Chinatown was to be closed down. They closed all the streets south of Thompson Street, and then they after that they closed it south of Canal Street. What do you think happened to Chinatown? What do you think happened to Chinatown?
Wasn't it about dusty? I heard.
What?
Wasn't it like really dirty from the dust in Chinatown as well?
Yeah. It's true. Dusty, and there's respiratory disease, especially PS124. You know the Confucius. You know that Confucius Plaza, that PS Grammar School. There's so many children, and the respiratory disease, and their family and the problem mental the health project. I think some of them follow, but the result I mean, nothing.
Well, that respiratory is only because it's recently brought up.
Yeah. Right? Yes.
But the other thing was, I know some of you don't remember. That's why, especially those who hunter that are taking the classes now. But Chinatown literally died because they couldn't allow any traffic south of Canal Street. And what happened was, what are the main industries in Chinatown? Well, at that time?
Sportswear factories.
The factories, the garment factories, and the restaurant. And then what was the other main industry?
Restaurant.
What is it today? Restaurants, right? People couldn't come into Chinatown to eat. And so Chinatown sort of just became a ghost town. And so that there had to be some drastic change. And I think a lot of you don't realize what Chinatown was before. And Ed brought that out very, very well, that it was very insulated, very isolated. The old folks had control. And they didn't want government money. Sometimes the government would come down and say, here's some money. And they'll say, no, we don't want it. Because they said, then you will dictate to us how we're going to act.
Control.
We don't want it. So that's how, that was the mentality at the time.
Yeah.
But then after 9/11, the community was in such a straits that they had a thank goodness the government came in, and that's when the new Chinatown became. And that's your story about all these new organizations that came in. And changed the whole mentality. People, whereas they fought each other and control their own money and so forth. Now they says, all right, this is government money. We have to share and we have to, you know, try to rescue the community. And that's when we all came together.
Yes, you were.
I think Ed was telling about some of that. Yeah. So with that background, you know, maybe somebody can, some of you have questions?
Yes.
Ed can answer?
I think the main thing, the whole thing is the partnership. Before, China was very hard to achieve partnership. Only partnership is...
I can't hear you.
Only partnership is Li Association, Ma Association. Not Li and Ma Association, they don't talk. You know, they don't talk to each other. And they only, that's only they trust. They don't trust Song Association, Ma Association, they don't talk. Now they all, you know, talking and the target, the issue and the problem is Chinatown. This is very important change. This is, I think, a democratic process, finally. Very, very beginning, don't say, oh, they might, no. Just very initial stage, very beginning, much better than before. Even we were a little bit, that's a blessing.
Do you think because of the change after 9/11, it's going to give the Asian community more presence in the city council and maybe in the mayor's office?
Yes. This is, I just mentioned that the 911 report service, that's a has great impact as I see. And the person doing this, not very verbal, not publicized. And I myself, everywhere I go, I always mention the survey. It's so powerful, so clear cut, because Americans, they always respect the statistics. We don't care. We don't do research, you know. Betty doing research, I'm not doing research. So statistics is a very, very important the power. We have statistics. How many restaurants close, how many factory close, how many jewelry store close, how many tourists come. They don't come. Restaurant, they don't come to food, they don't come grocery, they don't come. They don't come. That's very frightening. That's really, really very frightening for almost 6 months or something. You know, gradually. Even today, not fully recovered. Still not fully recovered.
Well, to answer your question, you say prior to recently, this last term, before John Liu got into the city council, we never had any representation in the city. In all these years, we never had any representation. And John Liu is the first person to become a member of the city council, and now we have Ellen Yang, who was his chief of staff. And now she's in the state assembly. So gradually, maybe we'll be getting some, and we hope the young people will get involved and volunteer, like Ed said, that we can do something
in all kinds of things. Because volunteer, you have a freedom. You know, your choice. You know, when you work, you have for money, you have no choice. But volunteer, you have a target. You can choose what you like, your hobby. You can achieve, you can get feedback. And this is very important, volunteer. So volunteer doesn't mean, oh, free labor, free, no. It's you are in control yourself, and you can do what you think you're the best to show, to job training, getting the best, and build your ladder, career ladder, step by step. And this is very, very important step for your future.
More questions?
I'd like to recognize Jimmy Yan, you know,
Jimmy
legal counsel from a board president, the man of board president.
From the borough president's office.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
See, we have representation. All of the elected officials now have community Chinese community liaisons. I think most of them do have a community liaison. And whereas we used to be ignored completely. And when we ask why, we'll say, you don't vote. And today, that's why it's very, very important to vote. So that when they see the voters come and they look at the rolls there, they will pay more attention to you.
Yes, this is very important. The regard, even we are Democrat, but we also support in Queens, like, you know, as long as they're good for, we just support them in the Republican world. Because you have no choice, you know, there are not much people around, you know, Democrat or Republican. And so in Queens, they're very, very active. People more participate. And this has something to do with the background of of China Canal Street, you know. But it's not easy happening today, you know. Oh, by the way, when I use email of this, you know, there's one woman called Chris Tran is a woman, and she's doing kind of art preservation art, museum preservation, and she says she has 10 meetings contributed by American Express. She wants to know whether Chinatown's any involve any preservation, historic preservation. So I talked with Bob Weber. Bob Weber is RCI executive director. I talked to him already. I would have emailed to him, let them contact, you know, whether there's a project can be connected. So we hope we can get them. Because of this, you know, can get $10 million, you know, from Maryland, this woman from Maryland. So I hope.
I want to hear from some of the companies.
Yeah, say something. Don't feel, you know, open your mouth.
No, I want to hear because you're Hunter College now is probably the only college that has a very viable Asian American program. You're in Asian American Studies, right? Mm-hmm. And I want to hear what's happening at Hunter. Because we are interested, the Asian American Research Institute is interested because we try to promote Asian studies and Asian American studies.
I'm a part of a club called KCCC, which is
talk up.
I'm a part of a club called KCCC. It's actually a Korean Christian community, and it's one of the most active Asian American clubs because they meet every week, they have events, and like if anyone like from Hunter, I'm telling them that you know they can come. If you want, you have sports day and stuff like that. And I just feel much closer in the community, you know, with Americans.
Are you a New Yorker?
Yeah.
Did you participate in any of the organizations that were listed up there?
No, actually no. This is my first year. I'm actually wanting to minor in Asian American Studies. Because now we can do that in Hunter. It's finally like offered this year that we can minor in.
You should talk to Dean Clay Scott. How about you?
I'm not in the club. No.
You're not in Hunter?
No, I'm in Hunter. I'm just not in the club.
Oh. And, did you take any of the courses?
About 4 years ago, I took Asian American in the U.S.
You did? You took that last year? Who taught that?
No, I took it 3 years ago.
Who?
I took it 3 years ago.
Three, four years ago.
Who was that?
I took it 3 years ago.
Three years ago?
Was it Peter Huang?
No, it was a Filipino guy.
Robert Koo?
It's also a P.
Peter Huang's still teaching, right?
No, he decided not to teach Asian American studies. He's into Chinese studies now. So Jennifer's taking care of it, and then they wanted to close it down. And that's when Irie got involved in it and said, no, you can't close it down. So that's why we have to constantly be on vigil to make sure that our interests are heard, because if we don't speak up, it's gone. Because when Dr. Kwong, you all know Peter Kwong. No, he was head of the Asian American Studies program.
He wrote several books about Asian American or Chinese, uh-huh. About a garment factory or something.
So we're trying to, you know, we try to keep the program and also the have Jennifer take over. So it's very important, and you have to, like I said, you have to talk to Dean Clay Scott. Yeah. And the president too, President Rob.
Yeah, you have to voice your opinion. You know what, let me say this, I have this. And during the last 800 meetings, news conference, I did come up, rising up. Why you, LMDC, why no Asian member? John Whitehead had that time. Yeah, you good question. Yeah, we didn't have. But they used to have a woman lawyer on the board, but she quit later. You know what I did? I deliberately wrote a letter to John White Hyde, apply for the position. I knew it was rejected, but I was testing for water. But anyway, because of the political situation, and then because so many things have back for Giuliani, Pataki and dominate, and then finally there's so many things running for president and release control to Mel Bloomberg. Finally, Mel Bloomberg organized six city commissioners, all commissioners, finance, and six by state, so we have no way in that. But this is the thing, they control a lot of law and land development, a lot of money. But even though their money is still limited, I don't know how much budget they have, but they're still very controlling. Now I forgot his name. He is the guy running LMDC, is Empire State Corporation, the whole New York economic development. This guy, I forgot his name. So it's still a lot of politics. That's why
I think we have it. I think Chinatown has the Empire Zone now.
Yeah, that's what we have. But in the beginning, no. In the beginning, give to Bruno, Hamilton. Come on, we are soon here, four or five blocks away. We don't give it to us. We suffer. We need help. We need money. We need this. Give to upstate. Bruno is a Republican majority leader. So he got it. After 2, 3, 4 years, hustling, bargaining, finally we got. Finally we got this. That means every hire, new hire in this zone, you get a store owner, get a $3,000 tax deduction. And many other benefits. This is important.
Maybe so, Jimmy can tell us about.
The Empire Zone is a state program that promotes economic development in areas that are considered economically distressed. And so it's after a long battle that Chinatown and actually part of the Lower East Side got an Empire Zone. The borough. Borough President, the Manhattan Borough President, Scott Stringer, has an advisory seat on this Empire Zone, and I actually sit on the Empire Zone on behalf of the Borough President. Councilmember Rosie Mendez also has an advisory seat. It's one of those things where it's great that Chinatown and Lower East Side has it, but there are a lot of questions about whether the zone can benefit the businesses that need it the most in Chinatown, because it gives, how it's structured is it gives tax incentives, tax breaks, tax benefits, tax deductions to businesses that hire more employees or invest in infrastructure, invest in equipment and facilities. But a lot of the Chinatown economy is not fully mainstream in terms of tax practices. A lot of the businesses that may need the help the most may not be able to get so much from the Empire Zone. So it takes a really, there's a lot of special effort that needs to be taken with this zone, different from all the other Empire Zones, to make sure that the community is really served by this and that it doesn't allow for businesses from outside the community to really benefit and displace a lot of the local businesses. So even though it's in place, it continues to be a very
You mean the people are resisting it? The businesses are resisting it?
Well, they because it's the benefits are tax-based, you could say they're resisting, or they're just not able to change their practices quickly enough to participate in it. And then there's a huge barrier that we face in probably in educating community members and businesses about the benefits. It's so complex. Tax, it's a scary word for most people. And it's a lot of these, there are quite a number of different tax benefits, a lot of which have very particular rules. So there's a huge task that our office is trying to work on, really has to be taken to really broadly educate the community on what these benefits mean to them and how they can get them. So it's
we have this wonderful thing that was given to Chinatown, but people don't understand it because there's a lot of tax benefits. You mean there's rebates and so forth?
Yeah, there are tax credits and tax deductions. Uh-huh. I guess the common
community concern is that a lot of Chinatown businesses don't pay their taxes, or they don't have main, because they're not, a lot of our new immigrants, they are not fully aware of best business practices, so it's not that they're trying to do something inappropriate. A lot of them are Chinatown businesses, immigrant businesses. It's not unique to Chinese Americans or Chinatown either. I mean, just generally new immigrant businesses are not so compliant with tax requirements. So because they are not aware of the benefits of that, it's hard for them to harder to understand the rules because of access problems, language, cultural, economic.
Who's educating the businessmen?
I'm sorry?
Who's educating them so that they will understand the benefits of being an empire zone rather than not having it?
It's the responsibility of the government to do that.
Yeah, yeah.
So in this case, the government is contracting with a community-based organization, which is an offshoot of Asian Americans for Equality. One of the biggest and best not-for-profits for Asian Americans in the city. So they're contracting with the government to do this. They've done some education, but not quite enough yet. And so our office is actually looking to design some materials and what more we can do. But it's really the mayor's office, the state, elected officials.
Well, see, again, the government is coming in. Now, I don't know whether any of you understand what the Empire Zone is, but it's something like a plum that you get, and you get designated, you get tax rebates and tax credits, like Jimmy said. But I think a lot of the people there don't understand what it's all about. And they say, no, 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 we don't want it. Just like when they used to come down with government funding, and they'll say, no, 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 we don't want it, because you know, that would involve outsiders coming in, and we have our community, and we can't control it anymore. So they said, no, we don't want it. But they have to be educated to understand what some of the benefits that the government is trying to do for Chinatown in particular.
Yeah. I think a business, I was invited to sign into law, you know, the entire zone mayor. And the business department, the city hall business department in charge of this. But as Betty said, it's a very functioning on the marginal. And this program, because the strips, so the rule regulations are so strict, some of the empire zone failed. Harlem and Brooklyn also failed. So it's tough.
Failed in what?
Failed, the poor failed. They just didn't have many people to come in Harlem. I think in one area in Brooklyn. You know, so it's not, as Jim just said, not just the discrimination, just the language, the cultural understanding and participation, and you know, they didn't want to pay taxes.
Not that, I think, because of the mentalities.
Yeah.
You know, like I grow up in Taiwan, so a lot of people, you know, grow up here. It's different, you know, the point of view. Even myself, another point of view. Afraid. I think when 911 happened, they helped a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
Ask you to, you know, sign in, you know, can get help, something. I think group of Chinese, I mean, living northeast side, they don't want to go because they are afraid, you know. Mm-hmm. I didn't pay tax, someone will come to me. And, you know, certain, they don't like to sign, don't like show the ID. You know, it's kind of, they like to have help, but one other side don't want to explore myself, that's it. Include myself too, you know, not only them, you know. A lot of things when they ask me, I don't want to answer. That's a mentality, I think. Something to do with me.
I think Dr. Ma also mentioned a professional manager.
Yes.
Isn't the Lower Manhattan Development Corporation now something akin to having a professional manager?
Yes. I think this has something to do with, let me say this, you know, we hire CPLDC, Chinatown Partnership Local Development Corporation, When this was established, John Liu, an office manager, and they were trying to find a professional as an executive president, there were several people. Nora Wong, Peter Lee, and then Valentin Chin. But as I see, Valentin is well qualified. He's a developer, he's an architect, a developer, he has his own company in Queens, you know. But there's a whole community uproar. Why, you know, some kind of behind the scene, you know, wishwash, you know, this kind of thing. Why doesn't give to this, why doesn't give to this position? There is $100,000 salary. So you can see this is, but at least I think the current, you know, I think Valentin's doing well, you know. She
How many people know about the Chinatown Partnership? Lower Manhattan,
or
is it, what is it called now?
Lower Manhattan Partnership and the Local Development Corporation.
Local Development Corporation. How many people know about that? Now they have a 2-year sort of grant?
Yes.
To bring about a lot of these changes and make almost, them permanent.
Yeah, like almost like every.
Uh-huh.
Now they give you money, better. After 13 times, you better rest your own phone. So now this CPLDC is running. They take care of the street clean, about 25, you know, staff clean the street. And clean the street and all take care of many things, but mainly they clean the street because the mayor, the people, tourists, all complain China the dirt, you know. At least this, I think, is doing very well. But there's so many things to need to greet the flower show every year, festival, and getting together, and you know, more agency with other community. I think everything doing very well. You know, really bring all the different forces, different groups, subgroup, coalition together. You know, instead of divisive, but more and more, you know, inclusive. You know, this is important. I think John Leo, the manager, is very good. I like him very much. He's a street smart, this guy. And he's managing. And I'm also on the advisory. I always remember once every month, one meeting every month. And all kind of agencies from China Manpower, from Republic, the O'Connor's office, the representative from Edinburgh's office, Margaret Chin was there. And there's so many agencies, legislative, city, and private, and CCB, also representative there. And so it's kind of the community-wide agency. So this is good. I think it's very, very good. And they're going to decide how to renovate the circle, Chancellor Circle, Chancellor Square, you know, the drugstore, the industry. You know, that square, the traffic is very, very bad. Chancellor Square, they're very, very bad. And so they're doing all these kind of neat things. And the information desk and near the triangle, Canal Street and the Baxter, you know, that's also they're doing. Of course, the dragon in a cage, you know, but anyway, better than them. The dragon, did you see channel, you see? The dragon in a cage. The dragon is Western dragon, not Chinese dragon. And the dragon in a cage, literally.
It's not in a cage.
It's almost.
It's on the top.
Yeah, almost like inside the roof, almost like a cage. You know. But if you feel anything, you feel like a burning cage.
Never thought of it as a cage.
Yeah, it's just several people complain, but anyway, it's better than known. It's better, no? I run into many tourists, where's the center of Chinatown? Because they want to go home. Oh, I'm in the center of Chinatown. That's here, Chinatown. So now at least the kiosk, you know, that information kiosk. The information desk, the information booth, is the center of Chinatown. And in the future, we're going to build Chinese art, also maybe around there, you know, because of traffic too much, pedestrian safety. So we don't know it, though. That's a future project. So we don't know.
Do you want to introduce your community board?
Yeah, Mr. Kevin Ma, my colleague, from community board, too. Now, committee board two. I have been committee board two for four terms.
Tell us what community boards are.
Yeah. Okay. Yes.
I'm going to sit down.
community board too, you know, it's kind of government, the basic agency, you better figure it out. Basic agency, really it starts. That's why I so very feel thrilled, you know, to have Chinatown Committee. This is the first time we are one step into the mainstream agency, you know, because, you know, Jimmy and the legislative counselor and we are there, and I'm there in 8 years, and Kevin, you were in there for 1 year almost.
Yeah, almost.
Yeah, you're
coming.
So that's also another board member, Raymond Lee. He's the business committee chair, you know, in charge of issue liquor license, all business establishment. You know, it's a sidewalk coffee. There's a, you know, it's an old woman, or watch your desk on the way coffee. Oh, one desk, only 6 chairs. Now 8 chairs. We have to correct. They watch every day the old woman, you know, on the sidewalk, you know, and these kind of things. So appointed by board president for every 2 years, you know, and representing. It's a good government democratic process. I think it's very, very important. Unfortunately, Chinese, you know, before me, I'm from on the CPC board, there are 4 or 5 people. The only female, they drop out. Why? Because the board meeting run until 11, 12 o'clock. So they drop out. But now at least 10, last night was almost 10 o'clock. And they're there, and so it's more active, and now in Chinatown.
Yeah.
I always interpret not only Chinatown, not only Chinese, because Italian, Korean, Japanese, all can join, you know, just a geographical reason, you know. And it's kind of, you know, geographical. Yeah, it's a geographical, you know, at least in name, we feel good in Chinatown, you know, at least we have a platform. You know, the platform we have a form, we can speak up. Before, we cannot have much. We have to rely on Jimmy, yeah, individually, oh, to do something for us, you know. Now we can speak in the platform, we do something. We have a legitimate place. And I read something, at least this is the first political acquisition. We get the first, you know, political acquisition after so many years. We have, you know, it's a really, really, it's, you guys have to work hard, register, vote. A lot of volunteer come, dedicate volunteer work, vote registration, and youth, yes. John Liu, the councilman, he's an excellent organizer. He organized the youth team, doing many things for community, volunteer, voter registration, doing many, many things. And he's really terrific, you know, John Liu, and doing a lot of things for community and just break the cultural barrier. I think I know most of his volunteers. I think sometimes Korean more than Chinese, because the Chinese, because the family, you know, I don't have to go there. You don't get money, why you have to work there? So more Korean involved, I believe, and then others, other ethnic group, Vietnam, from Malaysia, from, you know, that place. So, so okay. Yeah. Any other questions? Ernie, do you have a question?
What community for two?
Yes.
Does that involve the geography?
Oh, yes. Geography, I think I am, correct me. See, geographically, it's north of Canal, north Canal, north until south side of 14th Street. From 14th Street, 14, south side. From the east is Barber Street. On the west, west side of Barber Street until to the east, to the west, the river is quite large. And this group, I have to say, is politically very active. And Mayor Koch came from there, and they are very, very gay, lesbian. They are very, very politically very organized, very strong, very vocal, and very participate. I learned a lot from there. They're very politically, technically, very aggressive, very, very active, you know, in committee board too. And that's why I myself, you know, I always learn from them. And we are almost, you know, in Chinatown, you know, do you know, on West Side Highway driving south, you see there's a traveler insurance, there's an umbrella, you know, red umbrella at night. If Chinese, who cares? Nobody bothers. They're going to call every day, almost 6 months. Finally, I think take off. Finally take off. You know why? They complain. That right leg bothers my sleeping. The Chinese don't care. They don't care. Mm-hmm. Chinese don't care. They don't care. They scratch your skin. Sorry, scratching. Unless you can scratch your bone, then you're really mad. You can be very, very mad at Asian people. Otherwise, they just let it go. You know, don't want to be peaceful, don't want to get involved. This is the thing. We have to, you know, they always put their foot down, coming to board too. I think coming board too is organized better than other, I don't know, it's better than other groups. They are so aggressive. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. There's so many lawyers, political activists, and they are so. So yeah. many active political activists, community activists. So I learned a lot from them.
Alan Gerson is from
there. Yeah, Alan Gerson also from there. Alan Gerson was originally president of Community Board too. And before he left, he was chair of Canal Street Transportation Committee. I was his member, you know. And then he ran for city council and succeed. So. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Any more questions?
No more questions.
Not one. Thank you, Dr. Ma, for coming in.
Thank you. Thank you.